With Model Manager, administrators can create and manage their own custom models. In the admin tools, select the Model Manager option. Click Create Model and then enter some details. The namespace is a unique identifier for the model and is made up of a URI and a prefix. When you've completed the required fields, click Create. And you'll see that the model is now created with a current status of inactive. You can now start to build up the model by clicking on the model name. You can add both custom types and aspects to a model. Click Create Custom Type and enter some details. And when you're done, click Create. You can now click on the custom type name to add some properties to it. Click Create Property and enter the details that the property will be made up of. You can select what data type the property will be made up of, and you can choose if a property value is optional or mandatory. If you then click Create and start another, you can then create another property. Enter details for this property. And you can see that you can also add property constraints. This means that you can specify what values are allowed against the property. For example, if you select a constraint for a list of values, then you can enter what values can be selected. When you're done, click Create. And you'll see that both the properties are shown. Click Show Types and Aspects to go back a level, and next to the custom type, click Actions, and then Layout Designer. With the Layout Designer, you can define how properties you create are displayed. You can follow the on-screen instructions or just click to get started. Start off by dragging a layout element onto the layout area. You can then drag properties onto the layout area. Click on the header and you can add a UI label. When you're done, click Save and then click Show Types and Aspects. Next, you can create an aspect in the model. Click Create Aspect and enter some details. Now click on the aspect name and click Create Property to create a property against it. When you're done, click Show Types and Aspects. And then click Actions and Layout Designer to design a layout for the aspect. Again, choose a layout element and then drag properties onto it. And when you're done, click Save. Click Show Types and Aspects. And then Show Models, and then select Actions, and then Activate. And you'll see that the status of the model you've created is now active